Welcome back aspirants on MacTech 40, and today we will solve one question of scheduling and sequencing. Okay, and this question is very useful because in GATE exam 1 or 2 marks question, and this will be very easy to score this question. Okay, and because the other questions of industrial engineering your simplex method and graph chart, okay, that one optimization, so it consume maybe time, your part network, some there will be some error while calculation, there may be chance, but this portion is very easy. Okay, so what happens in this kind of problem? Here the question, that is in 2006 in GATE exam. This is the two machine one and machine two, and there are number of jobs and their cycle time is given for different machines. Like for P product, how to interpret this data? That is, the product P has to be machined in machine one and machine two, and for machining on machine one, the machining time is 15 minutes. Then it has to perform machine two and it requires 6 minutes. And one thing that is valid in real life, when you go to industry, you will find that, for example, if you want to welding, okay, two parts, but you have to prepare first butt edge. This is butt edge preparing we are saying. Okay, so you cannot say that first you weld and then you will do the bevel edging. First you have to do the bevel edging, then you have to weld this. Okay, there is a sequence that object or job must pass first machine one, do the operation on machine one, then machine two. This should be the sequence. Okay, so this is six jobs are given, like machine, sorry, must not machine, job Q required 32 minutes on machine one and 19 minutes in machine two. Okay, so what should be the sequence? Okay, like first which job I have to take so that my time will be minimum. Our objective here in this kind of question is to optimize our time product, this total product production time and the ineffective time, or you can say that the non-productive time. Like which kind of non-productive? Like your machine is ready, machine is continuously running, but job is not here. For example, I am giving the example. For example, a product which requires first rectangular slot and then chamfering. Okay, sorry, not, let's just take second example. Suppose there is one shaft, okay, and we have to do the facing and then drilling. Okay, these two operation. So what we are doing, we are not we are starting the lathe machine, and in during the continuous production, okay, we are not stopping this machine, because when you stop this machine, then again we have to start, so it will take starting power, and starting power is always more than running power. So again you have to do the setup. So first we are doing all the setup and machine is continuously running. Okay, like you are doing chamfering and then drilling, okay, but in different machine, okay, different lathe machine. So what happened when you, some in some case, what happened, you have done facing and on machine one, but machine two is already occupied while drilling. So what happened between machine one and machine two? There will be in process inventory. Okay, so this will be inefficiency. This indicate inefficiencies. Or in some case, like in sheet metal, first you make a hole here and then here you want some embossing. Okay, so you do two operation on two machines. So this is punching operation and here embossing. Suppose punching required 3 minutes and this embossing required 2 minutes. So what happened, machine one and machine two, here punching is operating and here embossing is going on. So what happens, it required 3 minutes, for example, make a punch in a sheet, but machine two is already free, it is continuously running, and but raw material is not coming here, okay, to make. So there is this is non-productive time. Yeah, for example, this machine 2 operator has to wait for 1 minute. So this is also a non-productive time. So we have to minimize this time of non-production, and we have to arrange this jobs in such a way that there should be a minimum production time and minimum non-productive time. So there are some rules. Okay, first rule is that I'll tell you that machine 1 and machine 2, the sequence you have to follow, and both machine will run at the same time. Okay, like at 9 a.m. to 9 a.m. Okay, both the machine will start. Then which job you have to take first, which job you have to take last. So there is a rule. This is the cycle time given. So select the cycle time which has minimum cycle time among all this. Okay, here PQRSTU, and here the minimum cycle time is 6 minutes. Okay, for job P. But you have to take the consideration that on which machine, if it is cycle time is on second machine, then you have to sequence it last P machine. Okay, the first rule is take the look at the cycle time, which is the minimum cycle time, and if it is on second machine, then put it on the last. Okay, then the second greater than this, the immediate greater than this 7. Okay, nearmost value, that is 7, but it is also in second machine. Okay, not for first machine. Again, put second last U. Then which is the higher value, just nearest higher value, that is 8. Okay, 8 is in first machine, so put R, job R, on very first. Okay, here I am putting job R. For example, this 6 would be here. If assume 6 was here and 15 here, so we will put P first. Okay, and let us take if 8 in on the second machine and 13 on the first machine, so we will take R on the second last. Okay, in the last in the sequencing. So this you have to take consideration while scheduling. Okay, not scheduling, sequencing this is called. So 8, then next higher most digit is 11. Okay, 11 again, it is in first machine. Okay, so put second number. So we have assigned R, we have assigned P, U, and T. Now S and Q remaining. So next higher integer greater than 11, it is 19, but it is on second machine, so you have to push last. So this is Q. So S, remaining one S will come on third place. Okay, so this is our schedule sequence. We have decided the sequence, and this sequence will give you minimum production time. Okay, or span time, minimum span time. Span time is from where your machine start and your production start, and that at time at which, for example, at t is equal to 0, at 0 time your production started, and at t is equal to, for example, 30 minute, your all the products finished. So your 30 minute is your time span. Okay, this is your time span. So we have to find the time span in this case. So how to draw this time span? So take here, first we have to give machine 1, machine 2, and divide two subparts, in and out time. Similarly for machine 2, in and out time. Okay, now write down the sequence RTSQUP that we have given. RTSQ QUP. Okay, this is our sequence. Now, how to calculate the span time? I am telling you. So, listen carefully. So, and always start with 0 minute. Okay. If the question is given in minute or hour, so take the units according to that. Okay. So that there will be no chances of error. So always start with zero here. Machine one at time 0 minute. I am taking time in minute. Okay. So at 0 minute, first product is coming R. Now R require 8 minutes. So after 8 minutes, it will come out from the machine one. Now we do not require any in process holding time. So just what we are doing for minimize production time, we will eliminate this non-productive time of inventory or in process handling time, just placing machine two beside on machine one, and at the out as soon as the material comes out from the machine one, it will enter into machine two like assembly line. So at 8th minute, it will enter into machine two. Now machine two, it requires 30 minute machining. So 8 plus 13. Okay, so 8 minutes enter and 13 minute exit. So at 21 minute it will come out. Okay, now this after 8th minute this machine is free. So as 8th minute T product will come, T job will come, and we will do the processing, and it require 11 minute. Okay, sorry, not minute, here it is given hour, sorry, it's my mistake, here it is in given hours. Okay, so we will take in hours, sorry for inconvenience, this is in hours. Okay, so after 8 hour we will take T on the first machine. Okay, this will do simultaneously. The first R product is machine on machine two simultaneously, while T is started machining at 8 hour. Okay, and it require 11 hours. So 8 plus 11, that means 19. At 19th hour it will processed, but when 19th hour is running, machine two is occupied. Okay, the one thing that is, at a time you can process only one product is processed. Okay, this is a fact. You cannot do multiple at a time. Okay, so what happened at 19th hours, this product machine 2 is engaged. Okay, while processing of R job. Now T job has to wait 2 hours, and as 21st hour comes, so this will be 21st hour, it will take in, go in, and machining time will require 14 hour. Okay, 21 plus 14, the out time is at 35th hour, this will come out from machine 2. Now this at 19th hour, here production started for S. So job S required 27 hours. Okay, so 19 plus 17 hours, I think, yes, 27. Okay, 19 plus 27 hours. So at 46th hour, this will come out from machine 2. Okay, first operation, but here machine 2 is already free and waiting for the another job. So this machine has to wait, and at the 46th hour this will come. Okay, now you might have questioned that sir, you have told that we have to minimize, but here it is going 2 hour delay here, and here almost 9 hour. Okay, but the sequencing that I am given here, I have done the sequencing this require minimum production time and minimum the non-product time is minimum in this sequencing. If you do like sequencing PQRST and as you calculate, so your mean make span time will be greater than the our optimum time, and your non-product time will be almost, maybe it may be less, but your total production time is more. Okay, so we have to do the analysis on optimal make span time. Here it is given optimal make span time, that means minimum time that will be required for production. Okay, so if you want to try, just try with another sequence, you will find out that how much variation and how much non-productive time and how much make span time is difference. Okay, so there at 46th hour it is start machining and machine product S require 20 hours. So this is 66. At 66th hour this will come out. Now at 46th hour Q is entered for processing and it requires 32 hours. 46 plus 32, that is 78 hours. Okay, so at 78th hour this will come out, but here machine 2 is already waiting from 66th hour. So at 78th this will enter and machine Q require, sorry, job Q require 19 hours. So 78 plus 19, that is 97. So at 97 hour this job is finished, machine 2, but here at 78th hour job U will enter for processing. So U require 16 hour. So 78 plus 16, so it is 94. At 94th hour this will come out. Now here what happened, job is ready but machine is not ready, it is occupied. So after 3 hours this will start machining at 97th hour. Okay, and U require 7 hours. Okay, so 97 plus 7, it is 104. So at 104th hour this job will be completed. Now here at 94th, okay, at 94th hour production of P start, P require 15 hours. Add 94 plus 15, that is 109. Okay, so at 109th hour the product P will come out from machine 1, but machine 2 is already waiting for this job. Okay, when you will come, so after 5 hours this come, and at 109th hour this production start, machining start on machine 2. So how much time require, it is 6 hour. So here 109 plus 6, that is 115. So at 115th hour our production will total completed. So from 0 to 115, so this is 115 hour is our optimal span time. Okay, if you have any question like why this is, there is some non-productive time also, always there is some non-productive time, you cannot minimize. Okay, there will be some minimum time in as well as in automatic machine process also. Okay, and as well as in manual also, but we have to design our process such that we can minimize the non-productive time as well as our total production time. Understand? If you want to try, then you can try to change the sequence RTSQVUP. Okay, so if you have doubt, then you have to tell me while PQRSTU by this sequence. You have to tell me by using this sequence what is the answer. Okay, in comment section. Okay, any doubts? So if you have any doubts, just ask in the comment section, and this is the homework for you. Okay, you have to follow this process in and out time. Okay, now tomorrow we will meet with one new question. Till then, keep studying, stay focused.